Good morning, Nativity, and everyone who's joining us via live streaming for this Mass on Tuesday of Holy Week. I'd ask that you keep in your intentions today the priests of the diocese and our bishop. Normally, we gather later in the morning to celebrate our Chrism Mass, but we will not be able to do that because of the current conditions, but we will be joining in together in prayer. And if you would, again, please pray for us. Also at that Mass, the bishop blesses different oils, the oil of chrism that will be used at baptism and confirmation and ordinations, the oil of catechumens, those who are entering into the church, and the oil for the sick. So if you would also remember those groups and individuals, those who are to be baptized, those to be initiated into the church, confirmed, and are sick, this is a special day for them. We ask God's incredible and good blessings upon them. We'll sing together a hymn. You can join in if you know it. It's called No Greater Love. And I think it's something that will reflect what you hear in the gospel reading and hopefully in my remarks during the homily. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. You will live in my love if you keep my commands, even as I have kept my Father's. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend. You are my friends if you keep my commands, no longer slaves but friends to me. All I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Now I call you friends. There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you. Friends, as we come together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, as we join together in prayer, let us ask the Lord to bless our faith, to strengthen our relationship with Him and with one another. We ask Him also to forgive us for those times when we failed to be friend to our neighbor. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and one another. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Lord Jesus, you intercede for us before the Father. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, grant us so to celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion that we may merit to receive your pardon. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear me, O islands. Listen, O distant peoples. The Lord called me from birth. From my mother's womb, he gave me my name. He made of me a sharp-edged sword and concealed me in the shadow of his arm. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me. You are my servant, he said to me, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Though I thought I had toiled in vain and for nothing, uselessly spent my strength, yet my reward is with the Lord. My recompense is with my God. For now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I will sing of your salvation. I will sing of your salvation. In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear and save me. I will sing of your salvation. Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked. I will sing of your salvation. For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth, from my mother's womb. You are my strength. I will sing of your salvation. My mouth shall declare your justice day by day, your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds. I will sing of your salvation. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Reclining at table with his disciples, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, Amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me. The disciples looked at one another, at a loss as to whom he meant. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out what he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, Master, who is it? Jesus answered, It is the one to whom I hand the morsel after I have dipped it. So he dipped the morsel and took it and handed it to Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot. After Judas took the morsel, Satan entered him. So Jesus said to him, What you are going to do, do quickly. Now, none of those reclining at table realized why he said this to him. Some thought that since Judas kept the money bag, Jesus had told him, Buy what you need for the feast, or give something to the poor. So Judas took the morsel and left at once, and it was night. When he had left, Jesus said, Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and he will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me, and as I told the Jews, where I go, you cannot come. So now I say it to you. Simon Peter said to him, "Master, where are you going?" Jesus answered him, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, though you will follow later." Peter said to him, "Master, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." Jesus answered, "Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me three times." The Gospel of the Lord. There is an expression that goes something like this: "Show me your friends, and I will show you your future." Show me your friends, and I will show you your future. It's a pretty understandable axiom. Our friends help to form us. Our friends also may be a bit of a reflection of who and what we are or what we hope to be. Show me your friends, and I will show you your future. In the scriptures, especially towards the end of the Gospels, Jesus calls those who are his disciples friends. Remember that phrase? He goes, "I no longer call you slaves," or "a slave doesn't know what his master is about. I call you friends. You are my friends if you do what I command, if you live in the command of love that I give to you. Show me your friends. I will show you your future." In today's gospel, which is set in the Last Supper, we see an exchange between, in particular, Jesus and Judas and Jesus and Peter. Notice in the gospel what Jesus does. He has a premonition about Judas' betrayal. He has a sense that Peter will deny him. But Jesus never denies the two of them. He is always friend to them, always hoping that somehow, some way, they'll use their free will and turn back to him to experience his friendship and his love. Jesus even feeds them from the Last Supper feast. He gives them a morsel from that feast, knowing that Judas is just going to walk out the door in a few seconds. He still feeds him with what we know now to be Eucharist. He gives them his own life. Jesus doesn't deny this Last Supper feast to Judas, but he is hoping through this maybe Judas's heart will be turned back to him. But Judas takes the morsel, and two things this scripture passage says. It says Satan entered him. Sometimes we have the impression that Satan takes us over. That never happens. Satan only becomes a part of our lives when we invite Satan into our lives. He enters in, much the same way that we open a door and let someone enter. That's what Judas did. And then at the end, it says, Judas took the morsel and left at once. And John describes for us, it was night. It was night, darkness, evil. Judas entered into that night. But Jesus, again, hoping against all hope, desires for us still to come back. There's still time for Judas to turn his life around. Later on in the gospel, Peter and Jesus have an exchange, and Peter says, you know, I pray that nothing will happen to you. I will lay down my life for you. And Jesus says, oh, you will do that? You know, before the night is over and the cock crows, you will have denied me. Even Peter, in denying Jesus, isn't something that puts Peter outside of this Last Supper meal. Jesus still feeds him. We gather for Eucharist, and I know we're enduring a Eucharistic fast now, but we gather for Eucharist not because we're saints, but because we're sinners, because we need to turn from darkness to light, because through friendship with Jesus, whom we receive in the Eucharist, we become, in a sense, like Christ, new creations, new creatures, filled with light and filled with his love. The message for us is clear. God never, ever gives up
on us. He is always the faithful friend. No matter what we do, where we go, what's happened in our lives, Christ is always faithful. He asks only that we turn back to him. This morning in our gathering, and each time we pray, is an opportunity to do just that. Let us turn our hearts, our minds, our lives over to Christ, our friend, once again. Trusting in the God who walks with us always, we bring our needs to our Lord and Savior. For all members of the church, may Christ strengthen us as we share the good news of the gospel. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For leaders and those who carry responsibility for the welfare of others, may Jesus guide them in their ways of servant leadership. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those struggling or suffering, especially in these times because of illness, because of a job loss, because of stress, may God's love and presence with them bring consolation and comfort, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all of us gathered in faith, may God open our hearts more fully and increase our faith in him, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the priests of the Diocese of St. Petersburg, for our bishop, for all of those who are united in ministry, that the Lord will bless us on this day when normally we gather for our Chrism Mass. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those whose lives and bodies are anointed with those holy and sacred oils, for the sick, for catechumens, for the elect and candidates who seek full initiation into church, for those who will be ordained, for God's blessings upon them all, and that their faith will be sustained, especially in this time of waiting and anticipation, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died, may they rest in the loving presence of our God, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. God of love and tenderness, faithful friend, we know that you carry us in our struggles. Hear our prayers today and give us all what we need to do your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably, O Lord, we pray, on these offerings of your family. And to those you make partakers of these sacred gifts, grant a share in their fullness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching.
by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, and your faithful everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. Let us pray for the coming of the kingdom as our Savior Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, we pray. Graciously grant peace in our days that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. You can offer each other a sign of peace, or use this time to pray for peace in our homes, community, church, and in our world.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you have fed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of eternal life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May your mercy, O God, cleanse the people that are subject to you from all seduction of former ways, and make them capable of new holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace and share the good news. Thanks be to God.